Hey guys, welcome to the Swapmoto Live Show presented by Ogio Powersports and FMF Racing. I'm Don Maeda, and today I'm joined by my buddy Genki Watanabe, who's a freestyle rider from Japan, better known to American fans as Wanky, right? So Genki, for those who don't really know your story, you know, you're from, where are you from in Japan?
Osaka, Japan.
Yeah. And you came to the US to be a freestyle rider.
Yes.
Yeah, so when did you come and how did it come about?
Oh, so I started to the freestyle motocross in 2010, then, but I really wanna go to the US. And it's Taka invited me 2011, and I first time coming to 2011. So like I stay only Faisal's house 3 months, zero English, never speak the English.
No English.
Yeah, no English. Just I say yes, no, that's it. And then this is my story, like first time coming to 2011. It's good times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so Taka told me his story. Taka Higashino is the other Japanese freestyle rider in the US, but he told me he just came with no plan, right?
Yeah.
And he came and just looked on Google Earth and found some freestyle ramps and he went and knocked on the door and it was Mike Metzger's house.
Right? Yeah, yeah.
So Taka did it the hard way, right? You had Taka to help you when you came, right?
Exactly.
So you came and he helped you meet people and take you riding?
Yeah. So like I understand he the hard way. He first time coming to the US, he don't have connection, you know?
Yeah.
And I know this story. Then my plan is so easy to away. I always stay in Taka with him. Like, he always like helped me a lot. He always bring to me like Deegan's house, like Faisal's house for sure, Twitch's house. Always, hey, this guy is from Japan. His name is Genki Watanabe. Nice to meet you, you know? So, yeah, he helped me a lot, I understand.
Yeah. Okay, so backing up a little bit, you were a IB2 racer?
Yeah.
So, national 250 class, like intermediate level racer in Japan. So, you started as racer.
Yeah.
And then transition into freestyle?
Yeah, so like I got a IA, like it looks like a 250, like a pro class.
Yeah.
But like I really want to get, I want to get having fun.
Yeah.
You know, like I don't know why Japanese racers sometimes so much like a stress for practice every day. I understand training every day, no day off. So like my fear like, oh, I want to try to ramp, you know, I want to try to skateboard something.
Yeah.
Looks like not having fun, you know. Then 1.5 years, I tried to IA 250, but like I feel like no fun. So then I asked Taka, hey, Taka-san, I need having fun for, then he said, for what? You try to freeze some motocross. That's why my mind changed.
Yeah.
And that day, 2009, in the summer, before the race, Mayhem. You know Mayhem, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, I first time hit like a 75 feet ramp on the 250 for like a supercross suspension. No, like looks like soft.
Yeah, outdoor.
Yeah, outdoor suspension. And first time I case on the 250, looks like a supercross landing. I almost eat shit. But in the second jump, I made it. I feel like, oh, so much fun in the freestyle motocross, it's fun. Then after that, I say, and I call my like a team manager. Sorry, I feel like right now is no motivate for race. So I want to left the race. That's why.
Just quit.
Yeah, 2009. Yeah, maybe August, yeah.
Excuse me.
Yep.
So, motocross, I tell people that motocross isn't very popular in Japan. It's kind of surprising to them because Honda, Suzuki, Kawasaki, made in Japan, right? Why do you think more people don't ride motocross in Japan?
Maybe too expensive for bikes. And super, I don't know why, like we have a big company in Japan. We have everything: Kawi, Yamaha, Honda, Suzuki. It's a big company, but I think bike is pretty expensive right now. It's normal people don't buy bikes, you know, for moto. The Japanese motocross culture is always it's same way. Now it's going down. Mm-hmm. They don't do the new style. Always same every year. 2001, 2002, 2003, 2004, 2009. That's why maybe big company like left for sponsorship.
Mm-hmm. So,
yeah,
hard to buy a dirt bike in Japan, right? Like you can't just go.
Yeah.
Order. You have to order it, right?
Uh-huh. So much waiting. So like, I think normally, like we order always like September, October. But always new bikes coming next year. Next year, maybe February or March something. Maybe we wait 5-6 months for a brand new bike. It's
okay,
pretty
so like a new dirt bike in the US is like $9,000, $10,000.
Yeah, yeah.
How much is it in Japan?
It depends. Like, my feedback is pretty close.
Yeah.
Like maybe 95 on some bike, maybe over 10 grand for sure, maybe Honda and mm-hmm. Yamaha, pretty expensive in Japan. Yeah, but we don't have a discount for a bike shop, you know? Some racer get like a discount and a free bike, but mm-hmm. it's for a freestyle motocross guy, never get free, never.
Yeah, but the freestyle scene is it really small? Or
yeah.
To me, it seems like it's kind of popular.
In Japan?
Yeah.
It's a few years ago pretty good. Uh-huh. That's why 2013-14 Rebel X Fighters is coming in Japan.
Mm-hmm.
Then we grow up and 2013-14-15 is a band show in Japan.
Yeah,
but now I don't know why, like last year I'm zero show in Japan.
Mm.
So yeah, like it looks like a popular, but sometimes I watch the TV, oh, freestyle motocross in the TV.
Yeah.
And some of my people, my buddy Taka sometimes riding, mm-hmm. Dice riding, sometimes Ego for sure. But yeah, people knows, but still and not famous in freestyle motocross in Japan.
So the compound is called 7-7?
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Is that like the only freestyle facility in Japan?
We have a motor track too.
It's like sometimes a ramp at the motocross track?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But 774 compound looks like a freestyle motocross, 100%.
Yeah.
We have foam pit, we have two quarter pipe and a bunch of ramps. That's why 774 boss like welding for he love yeah, make yeah. two ramps, everything. He like to make two landing, everything. So. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've been there.
Yeah, you've been there?
Yeah, I went with Cloudy.
Oh yeah, like yeah, yeah. I remember, like Cloudy so happy. You give to Jazzy, huh?
Yeah, yeah, we right? traded gear.
Yeah, I know.
He was wearing my gear.
I know, I remember. I remember.
Yeah.
I remember that year.
Yeah, we went 774 compound, and then I think the next day we went to Shidoki Raceland.
Uh-huh, motor track.
And, you know, Cloudy's paralyzed with a special bike,
mm-hmm.
the owner wouldn't let him ride the track because he says no professionals.
Uh-huh.
But Cloudy's not professional anymore, but he still wouldn't let him ride, so
mm-hmm.
Cloudy just watched all day.
I know. He already have a motivate every day.
Yeah.
He always watch the you guys and always watch the Supercross, always watch the, you know, like graphics, everything, helmets.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He looks like a kid, dude.
Definitely.
Yeah.
I really miss Cloudy.
I know.
Were you
too.
Good friends with him?
What's up?
Were you friends with Cloudy?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. Like, we come to 2015.
Mm-hmm.
We come to Temecula together.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, and we stay at Taka's house, but he want to stay at Taka's house, but he can't. So he stay motel or something.
Mm-hmm.
And me and Taka every day driving to Cloudy.
Yeah.
We bring up, then we ride every day like a fighter's house and fits.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're having fun.
He was pretty good at whipping that crazy motorcycle, huh?
Yeah, good, dude. I can understand he, you know, like he can move on down
just
here,
down, yeah,
yeah, right? But he's still doing it. Steve Burns weight pretty big.
Yeah, yeah.
And in foam pit too, crazy, yeah, in Japan, yeah. 774 compound. He never stopped every day trying to see Burns whip. I wanna get X Games best whip. I wanna get X Games best whip every day. Dude, he's a legend.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if you guys don't know, Cloud Tota was a former Suzuki factory motocross racer, and he was involved in a tragic accident in Japan and became paralyzed from mid-chest down. And then following Ricky James,
yep,
he built a motorcycle with the cages for his legs and kept riding moto. And then he got interested in freestyle, and mm-hmm, he was hitting the ramps. And his dream was to get invited to X Games for best whip, or like when they had the X Games like handicap race.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, yeah,
he
yeah,
wanted
yeah
to do that.
That, yeah, yeah.
They got rid of that event. And so he's like, I'm gonna do best whip. He was obsessed with that. But tragically, he passed away, because at the 774 compound that we're talking about, he jumped in the foam pit. And as it happened, sometimes the bike in the fumes ignited the foam, and yeah.
Yeah.
It's terrible,
that
he was burnt.
Yeah.
But yeah, so bad news there. Yeah. But not to end on a bad note, but we're gonna take a quick commercial break. We'll be back for more with Wanky. Hey guys, welcome back to the Swapmoto Live Show, presented by Ogio Powersports and FNF Racing. Once again here with Genki Watanabe. So, hey, Genki,
what's up?
Means good, right?
Yeah, fine.
Fine?
Yeah.
So your name is like Good Watanabe?
Yeah, Fine Watanabe or Good Watanabe, yes.
That's pretty, Japanese names are kind of like that, right?
Yeah, like
name
like
is also
Sky, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
My one of my best friends, his name is Forest,
yeah,
Hayashi.
Oh, okay.
Hayashi means forest, right?
I know, yeah.
So his name's Forest.
Okay.
But
Japanese.
Okay, so you changed to freestyle.
Yep.
Came to the U.S., but you don't live in the U.S. full time, right? You don't have a green card yet, so.
No.
Do you come on athlete visa or work visa or?
I just gotta get athlete visa right now.
Uh-huh.
But and used to be I always come ESTA,
mm-hmm,
so like a max 3 months. That's a 3 months.
Yeah,
that's why I'm so scary. Like last year I come a lot, 2 months and a half I stay, go back in Japan, just mm-hmm 10 days stay in Japan. They yeah come back. Always immigration is so hard for me.
Yeah,
always ask me so much question. You know,
mm-hmm,
that's why like then I already had X Games. So, like, it's Monster Energy gave to me the chance for visa.
Mm-hmm.
Then we work together for visa guy.
Yeah.
Then and 2 weeks and a half, 2 weeks, 2 weeks before, 2 weeks ago, I just get a athlete visa.
Oh, nice.
Yeah,
yeah. How long can you stay on that?
4 years.
Oh, 4 years.
So, yeah.
That's good.
But I have recommendation for like end of March, so I need to go back in Japan.
Yeah.
Maybe a couple of weeks. Then, and I want to go to interview for visa, everything mm-hmm clear. They give to me the new passport.
Mm-hmm.
I got a visa.
Nice.
So can't wait.
Okay. So you said you, when you came, you spoke no English, right?
Yes.
So did you learn just from talking to guys, yeah, or did you study?
No, I never study.
So your English is half bad words, half good words.
All bad words, dude.
So who did you learn the most English from?
Who gave it to me English?
Yeah.
Twitch. Fize. And Vicky always teach me good English for me.
Yeah.
But Twitch always give me a fucking shit English, always. All the time.
Yeah.
That's why I talk shit every day.
Yeah.
Hey, sometimes I ask Suze, his wife.
Suzy, yeah.
Yeah. Is she so mad? Jeremy.
Don't teach him that.
Don't teach him. Why you always talk shit for him?
Yeah.
But I don't care, just having fun, you know.
Having a good time.
Yes, I'm fine.
Okay, so Twitch gave you your nickname, Wanky.
Yes.
Tell me that story.
So, this is a long story. I first time coming to 2011.
Yeah.
I stayed Faisal's house, and I first time meet to him. Mm-hmm. My name is Genki Watanabe. I'm a big fan for you. Nice to meet you. Oh, Genki my Wanky-san, he said. Dude, Genki my Wanky, what do you mean? He said, oh, Genki my Wanky is Genki my Wanky. Nice to meet you, bro.
Okay, so have you seen the movie yet?
No.
16 Candles?
No.
Oh, the character is supposed to be a Chinese guy.
Yeah.
His name is Long Duck Dong. But he says, Yankee my Wanky.
Really?
Yeah.
Then, and we ride every day, but he always, hey, Genki my Wanky, son, what's up? Oh, Wanky is my favorite. He gave me a nickname. Okay, I use Wanky, and I change Instagram name.
Yeah.
Wanky338, I do. Then, but some people ask me, hey, who's call you Wanky? Who's calling you Wanky?
Yeah.
Twitch. I say Twitch. And you know me, Wanky? No, I don't know. Then 2 years later.
Yeah.
And 2013 or 14, and I searched Google Wanky.
Yeah.
Mean the fuck. I feel like, oh my god, too late.
Yeah.
You know?
I thought it was masturbation.
I know. I'm god damn it. But too late, you know?
Yeah.
People always call me, Wanky, what's up? Wanky, what's up? And, oh, hey, what's up, me? So, yeah, I feel like bad a few years later, but oh, okay now.
Okay, the 338 though, is that for J-Law?
J-Law, yeah.
Yeah?
So like, this is good memory from 2014.
Mm-hmm.
Then I go power raceway, and mm-hmm, I wanna hit ramps. Then J-Law come to the practice.
Mm-hmm.
I first time meet him. Oh, I like J-Law too.
Yeah.
I like his style, and I like his lifestyle. Then, and he said to me, "Hey, Wanky, we need to trading jersey.
Uh-huh.
Trade.
Yeah.
I'm so stoked. But he no more 338.
Yeah.
He put the number as 811.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know, but
Josh Lichtel, yeah, his friend who died.
Ah, really? Yeah. That's why. Then he rides Suzuki 450. Hey, Wanky, you wanna trade all gear? Then he gave to me like a full set, mm-hmm, full kit. I give to him like a full kit.
Yeah.
So then, Wanky, you like 338? I like 338. If you want, you keep it using my number.
Yeah.
Then he gave to me number, 338. Yeah. That's why I put 338 still.
Yeah.
So it's going to be good memory from 2014, yes.
Ah, that's cool.
Yeah.
Okay, when you came to the US, you know, you moved in with Feist and then Twitch eventually.
Yep.
What was your learning curve like? You, when you came to the US, were you already a good freestyle rider or kind of beginner?
I first time tried to backflip 2014,
mm-hmm,
from Paralesway. Then after backflip, they give to me the show a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know why, but looks like no beginner. Mm-hmm. But I already get show in Japan, so looks like no beginner, but and I already have a turn down in a long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that's why we ride every day, grow up little by little. Mm-hmm. Then right now, so.
Okay, so when was your first X Games?
X Games, 2015. Then they gave me a chance like speedrun style. So, but we don't have track in Japan. So I never had a supercross track.
Yeah.
And freestyle. Then, and me and my buddy make the supercross track in Japan. And but it's super small, yeah. You know? I don't know how to do that. Then, and after this, and I talked to Fais, hey, I wanna ride your compound practice for X Games. He said, oh, come. Then I go. Then, and 1 month before X Games, I ride every day his compound, but it's good. It's pretty technical, but for me, it's good, good, comfortable. But I never do practice in ramps. Mm-hmm. I only practice in the supercross track.
Yeah, it's then rusty.
Yes, it's good. Then, and after that, I died 2015 at X Games, like Austin. Yeah, Austin, yeah, mm-hmm. In a practice. So hard for me. Mm-hmm. I'm pumped for tricks. I don't know how to do that. I want to try to couple flip tricks, but I can't. Mm-hmm. I'm pumped, you know?
Yeah.
Then I don't know timing. You know? So it's 2015. Then maybe qualify. Yeah, I ride with Birko. Mm-hmm. Then I crash, and back corner, crash. Then maybe I get maybe 7th place, maybe. Mm-hmm. Yeah, don't go final. Yeah, that's why my first time X Games story. Yes.
Not so good.
Not so good.
Okay, we're gonna take another quick break to hear from our sponsors, but we'll be back for one last segment with Wanky.
Don't try to be the fastest on the track.
Be the fastest ever. Work harder than everyone else.
Because dedication is everything.
If they say your goals are crazy,
be insane.
Be fast.
Be the crazy one.
Be unstoppable. One goal, one vision.
We put our heads together to both reimagine and lift the bar on what a modern motocross helmet should be. Opt for the highest level of modern technology and energy dispersion with the Fly Racing Formula helmet. Designed for an elevated defense against a wider range of real-world impact scenarios. Globally engineered with the most advanced materials and technologies available. Outfit yourself with proven technology, lightweight performance, and elevated impact management with the Fly Racing Formula helmet.
What's up, guys? It's Brock Tickle. I ride for the JGR Yoshimura Factory Suzuki Racing Team, and I'm stoked to be back at the races. Planning my comeback to racing was cool to see. I have a lot of support behind me to get me here. FXR stepped up and invested in me, and I'm stoked to be part of them. FXR honestly kind of blew me away. All the product is awesome. The pants fit me awesome. The best fitting pant I've ever worn, and everything's sublimated and it looks good.
We'll be right back.
Hey guys, welcome back to the Swapmoto Live Show presented by Ogio Powersports and FMF Racing. Here with Genki Watanabe, who since that start in X Games, you've got a couple of X Games medals, plus the best whip win at Monster Cup, the Dirt Shark contest. Mm-hmm. So I think you're most famous in the U.S. for your big whip, right?
Yeah.
How do you whip it so good? Like, have you ever crashed from going too far and not?
I don't know why. Like, for me, turn down pretty easy. Mm-hmm. And I first time tried to turn down in 2010.
Yeah.
And I do in Japan, only in Japan. But people, you turn down insane, dude. But I just tried to couple, like, you know, like same style for whip.
Yeah.
Then beginning, I crash sometimes. Over jump, super indo, you know. Mm-hmm. But sometimes pretty scary, like for try to 180, you know.
Yeah.
But, and now it's about, I run C-band sweep right now, but for me, so difficult.
Mm.
That's why I always talk to like TV from Tyler Bierman.
Yeah.
And I asked Axel, I asked Twitch, everybody, I really want to get fucking C-band sweep right now.
Yeah,
so whip is hard.
Yeah.
Yes, even technical for me.
So you're always in like best whip contest, right?
Yeah.
How come you never do the freestyle competition? Because you do all the tricks, right?
Kind of, yeah. But now it looks like a freestyle motocross contest is pretty gnarly. They do double backflip, they do front flip, flare,
Vario.
360, body out, so many tricks. I used to be try to, like 2018, something. I want to try to maybe body barrier. I tried to foam pit, but dude, so scary. Then I want to try to 360. I tried to 2015, like in foam pit, so hard. And then 542, so hard. Double backflip, never try, but dude, looks like so scary.
Yeah.
That's why like, I feel like maybe I want to try to another way.
Yeah.
So, I still like freestyle motocross trick, but pretty gnarly for me, you know?
How about, you know, because you're a racer originally, you have good bike skills. Are you good in the hills? Like you go to the hills with Twitch and Axel, can you do the natural stuff?
I try to.
Because I've been in the hills with Taka, he's no good.
I saw one time, long time ago, I ride with Taka-san.
Yeah.
But Taka-san always tried to freestyle trick for like a step up on.
Yeah.
He tried to rock side flip, he tried to everything. Body barrier, no problem. But I never see his hip.
Yeah.
I never saw that. But, and, but I want to try to. I sometimes go into maybe end of February, a few years ago. I want to try to whip, but it's pretty hard for me. Like, you know, third gear, I never tried to third gear pin it, like a hit.
Yeah.
I never do that, so I want to run.
Yeah.
I really want to run, yeah. It's pretty sick. I like it.
Okay, so one of the, you know, I only met you maybe last year, right?
Or yes.
Year before, but, you know, I was aware of you. And, Roger told me, oh, our freestyle guy, Wanky, he's sick. And he says he chose you because you pay close attention to your everything, the style, the setup of your bike and everything. Mm-hmm. So is the style and design is very important to you?
Yes, it's very important. So like Roger helped me start to get 2017, but he always talk to me like Geneva Supercross 2014-15. I first time talking to maybe 2015. Then he always like, hey Wanky-san, what's up? Hey Wanky-san, what's up? But he never say, hey, you wanna join my team?
Yeah.
He never say me. But I feel like end of maybe 2016. And we talked to Geneva Supercross, and then he said to me, hey Wanky, you want to join my team? You want to come 7? I said, yes. Mm-hmm. That's why you guys are looking sick. Yeah. Bike looking sick, gear so sick, always match helmet, gear, boots, bike, graphics. So I love clean, so
yeah,
I'm pretty stoked right now.
Yeah, clean. Clean is one of your favorite words, right?
Clean, yes.
You always say clean.
Clean is, yes, I like my word, I like clean, but Axel too, maybe, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I love clean, you know, exactly. I wash every day, you know?
Yeah. Okay, so you're one of your big sponsors is DBK, right?
Yeah, nice, nice, yeah.
Dirt Bike Kids.
Yeah.
So you're wearing your signature hoodie, right?
Yes, chic quality. Yeah.
Where That's does funny. That saying come from?
This one?
Yeah, sometimes I see your Instagram.
Yeah.
You know, good whip, you're like, oh, quality whip.
Uh-huh.
And if it's no good, you say shit quality, right?
So that means pretty funny story too. Like, last year, like before X game, Minneapolis. So me and Twitch go to the Canada. Like, Keith Seiya gave to me the 10 days show, like Stampede, Calgary Stampede. Mm-hmm. It's a big show in the fair. So like we stay 10 days, we having fun, talk shit every day. Then my buddy James Carter, you know James Carter?
Yeah.
And James Carter bring to New Jersey and print a name.
Yeah.
But his print a name, just one lighting, after take off the name.
Yeah, yeah.
So I say, hey James, you named shit quality.
Nice.
Then next day, same shit.
Yeah.
He bring another jersey, but take off. So then I talk to every day, James, you are shit quality. Shit quality. I use every day.
Yeah.
That's why like, and the Twitch is always filming me.
Yeah.
And James too, like Kiseya too, they filming me, Shoei quality.
Yeah.
Then, and I don't know why, like after X Games, people like Shoei quality, hashtag Shoei quality.
Yeah.
You know? I'm wondering, dude, like, everybody use.
Hey, it's your own saying. You invented it, right?
So, that's funny.
Okay, coming here from Japan.
Yeah.
In the US, you know, I know a lot of people in Japan, they look California,
yes.
And they all want to go Disneyland and stuff, right? But what is your favorite thing about being in the United States?
Vegas.
Las Vegas,
yes.
You like it?
Yeah.
I thought Las Vegas is bad memories.
I know, 2018, my legs fucked up, but after that year, 2019, I got a gold helmet.
Yeah.
I got a first place.
Yeah.
It's, last year is, dude, super good memory for Vegas.
Yeah.
So that's why I like now Vegas.
Okay.
So
what about US for food? What do you like to eat here?
In the US, no Mexican food.
You like Mexican food?
Yes, I like burritos so much.
Yeah.
Aztec tacos is the better.
Oh yeah. Right. Near Cahuilla Creek, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Like a California burrito.
Uh-huh.
My best food ever.
The French fries inside.
French
right?
fries, yes.
Yeah. Okay, so when you're in the US, what do you miss the most about Japan?
Is my family.
Mm-hmm.
And my family and my wife too. And
You're married?
Yes, I got married 2 years ago.
Oh, I didn't. Yeah. She's in Japan.
She's in Japan, yeah.
Why don't you bring her?
No, she don't like
a job?
She don't like in here.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she don't speak in English.
Oh.
That's why. But she live in Japan, she have a job too. So like I miss so much Japanese food right now.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's very important for food for me.
Yeah, what is Japanese food in the US like for you?
Sushi?
No, but like is Japanese food in the United States kind of not so good? Is it shit quality?
Sometimes shit quality, but some shop pretty good.
Yeah.
Like San Diego is pretty good.
Yeah.
But Temecula, so-so.
Yeah.
But I like rice, whatever, you know? I go Panda Express. I go some like cheap sushi shop, you know?
Yeah.
I don't care, I like it.
How come in the United States, there's Japanese restaurants, always so many other kind of Asian people working, like Koreans and Chinese in Japanese restaurant, right?
So weird.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know why. Some people, it's one time some people like mad me, maybe Korean people, I don't know why. But I don't understand why they use Japanese restaurant, Japanese name,
yeah.
But I never see Japanese chef.
Yeah.
Everybody is Korean.
Yeah.
Korean make Japanese food.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why.
I don't know. I tried to explain that to Twitch. He doesn't understand.
Yeah.
So hey, we're about out of time.
Yep.
But dude, I'm super pumped that you came down to the show.
Me too.
It's been great to get to know you over the last mm-hmm. year or so. And I look forward to coming out and shooting some.
Yep. Let's show. Let's go.
Yeah.
I really want to get.
Thank you
so much.
Alrighty. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to follow Wanky at Instagram, Wanky338.
Yes.
And yeah, go to DBK and buy your shit quality
yep.
sweatshirt. Thanks for watching. See you next time.